How we doing today, YouTube? D-Ski from D-Ski Grills back with another cooking video. And today, we are grilling up some cherry smoked halibut on the Weber Summit Charcoal Grill. Folks, can't wait to show you this cook. Very, very excited. Can't wait to show you. We're going to introduce some more of the accessories for the Weber Summit Charcoal Grill. These are accessories I picked up maybe a year and a half, maybe 2 years ago. Pulling them out, getting them reintroduced, just to show you how versatile the Weber Summit Charcoal Grill is. So here's what we got, folks. We have one beautiful filet, one beautiful halibut filet. We're gonna use the Weber accessory skillet. We're gonna season this halibut with fish seasoning, mixed herbs, basil, oregano, and you know, no fish is complete unless you sear it with some good old butter. Okay. Now we'll also go ahead and actually prep our pan. We can do that while we're together right now, just to make sure that we have some oil on this cast iron pan. All right, so you know what we'll do? I'll take you step by step. I'll show you how we're gonna season. We'll go out there, we're gonna use the Vortex as well today. So really fun stuff, okay? We're gonna use the Vortex. We're going to use the skillet. We're going to sear up some beautiful halibut, add a little cherry smoke, sear it on both sides, all these awesome spices. Before you know it, we're at the cutting board checking out awesome cherry grilled halibut on the Weber Summit Charcoal Grill. I want to thank you as always for joining me, and let's get cooking. Okay, folks, we're back at the cutting board. You can see this beautiful flaky halibut that we have here. Now, I've showed you before we got started that we went ahead and added cooking spray to our cast iron skillet griddle pan. So let me move this to the side. Okay, we'll bring the fish on into the frame. Riley is acting up, if you can hear him. And we're gonna go ahead and start the seasoning process. So here's what we got going on. We're gonna use our garlic roasted olive oil. And we want a generous portion because remember, we're doing a sear, okay? So we wanna make sure that the pan has oil in it. We wanna make sure the fish definitely has enough oil as well to try to minimize the sticking process while we're cooking this beautiful piece of fish. All right, so we have that one side done. Go ahead and flip, and we'll do the other side as well. Beautiful, look at that, it's wonderful. Pick this up at Costco as well. Now this is an awesome light fish, folks, and I'm telling you, you're talking about springtime with maybe some good garden vegetables and things like that. This is a lighter side of D-Ski Grills today on this video. Can't wait to show you the final product too. Beautiful flaky halibut. Okay, so we have that done. So now we're just gonna come back with our spices. So our fish seasoning, I wanna go heavy with that. All right, so let's get that added. This is good stuff. And if you taste this, you know, you taste all kinds of lemon hints and things like that. So it's the perfect seasoning for fish. Nice coat. Because at the same time, folks, you know we wanna try to build up a crust, all right? So we're going for that as well. Flaky on the inside, crust on the outside. Going to make for a phenomenal final product. Okay, so we have that. And then again, I told you we have mixed herbs. All right, so let's go with those. Hopefully Riley doesn't bark again, but it seems like he's about to. He is upset about something. Riley is 8 months with us now, so he's a straight up family member now. Okay, so we got that. Now we're coming with our basil. All right, this came out a little bit more than I thought, got confused. All right, so we have a nice little coat of basil. We wanna do the same thing with our oregano. Drop a little bit of oregano on here. Okay, folks, then we're gonna flip and repeat. So let's do the same on the other side. Okay, so this is what we have going on. We'll go ahead now, get our herbs moved around. And folks, I'll meet you outside at the Weber Summit Charcoal Grill. We can check out the grill setup today while this fish soaks in all of these awesome seasonings. Okay, folks, we're back. So anyone who follows me on YouTube knows that I am such a fan of the versatility of the Weber Summit Charcoal Grill. So what I want to do is show you the grill setup for today. I'll bring you in closer in a bit, but I just want to show you just some of the different nuances and the awesome things that this grill offers, okay?
First and foremost, you know we have our grill grate, but we have our center cutout that comes out, right? This is a part of the gourmet barbecue system, right? So you can take this out, and they make it a point to have somewhere for you to put your stuff, right? So here it is. There's our insert. We can hang that baby right here, out of the way. No harm, no foul, all right? We're using the skillet today. We talked about that at the cutting board. So here's our skillet. The skillet goes right in place, fits perfectly right there, okay? I'm telling you, it is well thought out. There are so many accessories for this grill. I love this one, and I love all the rest of them as well. So let me bring you up close and show you the grill setup. But this is where we're going to have extreme heat coming right up under the bottom of the skillet. Our halibut will go right here. We'll keep it on here for maybe 3 or 4 minutes. Flip it 3 or 4 minutes again. That baby will be done, okay? So it's all about the hot, high sear to build that crust and to lock in those flavors. So I'll bring you up close and show you what we got going on. Let's take this back out. So how are we going to achieve those hot, focused type temperatures right up under that griddle? You guessed it. We're going to use the vortex. Let me get this out the way. So we have the vortex. This is the large vortex for the Weber Summit and the Big Green Egg and all those different type kettles, right? So this baby, we're going to add lit coals onto these unlit coals, right? So that's the plan. Once we do that, it's going to be concentrated heat going right above, right on that griddle, okay? So let me put the lid back on and show you again. This is straight up show and tell time. This is good stuff. So here's our open spot. Here's our beautiful skillet. Fits perfectly. And voila, we are pan searing outside on the barbecue grill. So I'll get this thing lit, fired up. Once we get that vortex ready, we'll come out. We'll put this in place, right? Our skillet. And then we're going to add butter, okay? We're going to infuse this thing with butter also. We're going to add butter in the skillet. Let it start melting. Drop that halibut on. 3 or 4 minutes. Flip it. 3 or 4 minutes. Meet you at the cutting board. So we'll get together when it's time to get this fish going. See you guys in a bit. Okay, so now we have the concentrated heat. So now all we have to do is put this skillet right in place, okay? And then in no time flat, this skillet's gonna be piping hot. It'll be time to add this halibut. All right, so let's not forget about our smoke. If you remember, this is called grilled cherry halibut, okay? So let me show you what we have. We have our cherry wood. This is our Western chunks. So we're gonna get a chunk of that added. But I'm not gonna add it until I'm ready to start cooking, okay? So this one chunk is what we're gonna add to the fire. Then we'll get the rest of the grill set up ready, okay? But I wanna bring the fish out first because this is gonna be all about timing, okay? So let me put this to the side. I'll go get the fish, we'll finish this grill setup, and it'll be time to do my favorite part of the video, and that's let's get cooking. Okay, folks, let's finish the grill setup. I'm stepping into the camera, I apologize for that, but here we go. Here's our cherry chunk. We're gonna add that baby right in the middle. All right, now we're coming back with our skillet. Look at this beautiful skillet. I'm gonna let this go for about 2 or 3 minutes. Then we're gonna add butter. And before you know it, the star of the show will be hitting this skillet. Look at this beautiful, beautiful halibut that we're going to cook today. Cherry smoke is starting to roll already. I can already smell it, so I'm all excited. Let's get our butter added. Doing about half a stick right here. Just add it right there. Okay, folks, I'm gonna get this shut down. We'll get back together in just a second. It'll be time to start the searing process, but let's make sure our butter is doing its thing and moving around. Look at that. This is what it's about, folks. You know on Deesky Grills, if it ain't flavor, we're not doing it, right? So we're all about building flavor on this channel. We have one magnificent halibut fillet to add to the skillet. We have cherry smoke starting to roll. All we got to do now is close it up, get back together in a few minutes once this thing reaches around 500 degrees. I'll see you guys in a bit. Okay, folks, so we are back. I want you to hear this sizzle. Listen to that.
That is the extreme heat starting to happen on the Weber Summit charcoal grill. That's our butter starting to sear right into that cast iron skillet. Here's our temperature right now. We're at around 340 and rising. If you just look at that dial, you'll see the extreme heats that the Weber Summit charcoal grill can reach in no time flat. Now we're at 350. I'll leave you there for another second. We're going to go ahead and put this halibut on because I can't wait any longer. We are moving up to 360, as you can see, and counting. All right, so let's put this down and let's do what I like the most, right? This is the favorite part of the video. Let's get cooking. We're going to get this baby shut down. I'm going to burp it. We have cherry smoke rolling. We have our butter cooking. It is time to add some halibut. Here we are, folks. Look at this right away. That's what it's all about. That's it. So we're going to let this sit here. We're going to let it cook for at least 4 to 5 minutes on this side. We're going to flip and repeat. All right. I'm going to add a little bit more butter while we're together. But remember, what we're looking for is an awesome sear on both sides, knowing that the flesh itself is going to be cooked internally. So we want an opaque type color when we do our first flip. All right, we'll get back together in about 3 or 4 minutes, and then we'll do our flip. See you in a bit. Okay, folks, we're back. It's been about 3, maybe 4 minutes later. It's time to do our first flip. All kind of excited, you know. You just hear all the sizzle going on here. Let's get it burped. Look at that. Look at that beautiful halibut. All right, let's see what we got going on here. Okay, I got my glove because I don't want to get burned. Oh, my Lord. Look at this is what we're doing on DC Grills, folks. Look at that beautiful charred side we have. This is what I'm talking about, okay? Now we're going to come back with more butter. Let's go back with a little more butter. Now, the whole idea, if you remember, behind the seasoning was to build that crust, okay? Now, the grill is kind of slanting this way. This is why I'm putting the butter right here on the tip and let it work its way down up under the fish, okay? This is what's going on today. I might raise the fish up to make sure the butter's going up under, but I'm sure it is. Really excited. We're going to shut it down, go another 3 or 4 minutes, and then I'll meet you guys at the cutting board. Okay, YouTube, we are back checking out the piping hot skillet of our cherry grill halibut made on the Weber Summit charcoal grill. Folks, listen to that sizzle. Let me stop talking for a minute. This is what it's all about, folks. What did we do? We started off with multiple seasonings. We had a fish seasoning. We had oregano. We had basil. We had mixed herbs. We added garlic-infused olive oil and coated it on this fish, right? Then we went on that Weber Summit charcoal grill using the Vortex, and we concentrated our heat right above the skillet, folks. This sizzle is not for play. Listen to it, folks. This is absolutely amazing. We built a beautiful crust. Now what we're going to do is do a quick taste test. But you know what? It's all about garnish too, right? Let's do a little garnish. Isn't that pretty? We'll add a little bit in our oil because we might actually put some of this good stuff on there. All right, we're going to do a taste test real quick. I'm going to start right here and just show you how awesome and flaky this is. This is fish done right. This is halibut done right. Look at that. Look at the beautiful flakiness cooked through and through. If you like what we're doing, please subscribe to my channel. Let others know what DC Grills is up to. And as always, at DC Grills, grilling is not a pastime. It's a passion. It is cherry grilled halibut time here on DC Grills. This is ridiculous. Folks, this is ridiculous. I need you to see the flakiness. I need you to understand what I'm saying. This is ridiculous. This is halibut done right. I have my beautiful wife on the side of me. This is her bite. I'll catch you guys on the next one.